Hey, good morning everyone. So I will be discussing our first topic for the semifinals in Rizal, which is the results annotation of Morga's work, which is the Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas. So the objective for this lesson is that by the end of this lesson, the students will be able to analyze Rizal's idea on how to read and study Philippine history, and second is to compare and contrast Rizal's and Morga's differing views of the Filipinos and the Philippine culture. So here are the topics that we are going to tackle for this morning. So first is the introduction. Second, we will delve into the book, The Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas. And then, we will be talking about the author, which is Antonio de Morga. And then, we will also discover why Rizal chose The Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas. We will be also looking at the influence of Blumentritt on Rizal. We will be also looking at the objectives or purposes why Rizal annotated the Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas. And then we will be comparing and contrasting the different points of view of Rizal and Morga with regard the Filipinos. And then the importance of Rizal's annotation to the present generation. So yeah. So just to a brief recap of what we discussed last midterms. So we ended with the life of Rizal abroad. I mean, we discussed the life of Rizal abroad, particularly his life when he was in London. So as we all know, Rizal spent several months in London to do historical research on pre-colonial Philippines. Kasi nga masyadong invested si Rizal sa history, so gusto niyang kalkalin ano ba yung sistema ng Pilipinas during the pre-colonial times. And second, to improve his mastery of the English language. So, yeah. Sabi dito, the arrival of the Spaniards contributed to the decline of the rich pre-colonial Filipino society and culture. Kaya gustong malaman ni Rizal kung ano ba yung sistema ng pamumuhay ng mga Pilipino before na dumating yung mga Espanyol. So, when he was in London, he was granted a reader's pass to the British Museum. And doon sa British Museum, natagpuan niya yung book ni Morga na Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas. And then he was so interested in that book, kaya ang ginawa ni Rizal, since hindi pa uso yung photocopy machine during that time, ginawa niya, kinopya niya through handwriting yung 351 pages na book ni Antonio de Morga. So yan yung history, short history kung paano niya na-discover yung book na Sucesos. So let's talk about the book Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas. So, the author of this book is Dr. Antonio de Morga. So, tungkol sa antong libro na ito. So, it's about an account of Spanish observation about the Filipinos and the Philippines. So, ang nilalaman ng librong Sucesos is yung kung ano yung na-observe ng author sa Philippines during the time na naisulat niya tong libro na ito. So, This book describes the events inside and outside the Philippines from 1493 to 1603. So, the Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas consist of 8 chapters. So, again, it is a documentation ng mga pangyayari or the observation of the author during the Spanish occupation. And this was annotated, not anointed, annotated by Rizal. And the prologue of the annotated book of Rizal was written by Ferdinand Blumentritt. So accordingly, Rizal is the secondary source of the book because he annotated the original Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas. So the Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas is one of the most important works of the Philippines about the colonization of Spain. Kasi in that book, ina-explain niya kung ano yung situation ng Philippines in terms of politics, social and economic aspects of the colonizer, which is the Spain, and the colonized country, which is the Philippines. So again, this is written based on the experiences, based on the observation, yung nakikita, yung na-experience ni Antonio de Morga, na author nitong libro na ito. So, what is included in this book is yung history of war, intrigues, diplomacy, and kung paano na-evangelize or na-convert into Christianity yung mga Filipino. So, Las Islas Filipinas, it talks about the Philippines, which was named in honor of King Philip II of Spain. When we say Sucesos, ito yung work of an honest observer, a versatile bureaucrat who knew the workings of the administration from the inside. So, sulat daw ito ng isang observer. So, itong observer na to, maaring may posisyon siya sa government or sa administration during the Spanish colonization. So, mamaya, madidiscover natin and bakit tinawag siyang Sucesos. Ano ba yung position ni Morga? Kaya pumasok siya sa term na Sucesos. So, as I have mentioned a while ago, the Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas is composed of 8 chapters. So, the first chapter talks about the first discoveries of the Eastern Islands. The second chapter talks about the government of Dr. Francisco de Sande. Third chapter talks about the government of Don Gonzalo Ronquillo de Peñalosa. Fourth chapter talk about the government of Dr. Santiago de Vera. Fifth chapter talk about the government of Gomez Perez das Mariñas. Sixth chapter talk about the government of Don Francisco Tello. The seventh chapter talk about the government of Don Pedro Acuña. And the last one, an account of the Philippine Islands. So basically, yung first 7 chapters deals with the discoveries, conquest, and other events hanggang sa pagkamatay ni Don Pedro de Acuña. So yung first 7 chapters, as you can see, palaging on the government of. So, tinutukoy dun sa first 7 chapters yung mga different accomplishment ng mga governor general na na-assigned dito sa Pilipinas. So, bakit instrumental daw yung Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas sa pagsulat ng history ng Philippines? Because Rizal considered it as necessary to invoke the testimony of illustrious Spaniard who governed the destinies of the Philippines. So now, let's move forward with the author. So, let's talk about yung pamumuhay ni Dr. Antonio de Morga. So, si Dr. Antonio de Morga, so his full name is Dr. Antonio de Morga Sanchez Garay, and he was born in 1559 in Sevilla, Spain. So, si de Morga, he was a Spanish lawyer, soldier, and high-ranking colonial official. So, one of the most prominent contribution that the Antonio de Morga made is the book Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas. So, again, the Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas provides a detailed account of the Spanish colonization in the Philippines. So, yun nga, ang nilalaman niyan is yung mga insights ng author regarding sa political, social, economic, and cultural aspect of life in the Philippine archipelago during the Spanish colonization. So, the book covers topics such as governance, trade, religion, customs, and indigenous peoples of the Philippines. So, bakit Sucesos? So, di ba, sabi dun sa definition, Sucesos is a work of an honest observer, usually part of the administration. So, isa siya, considered, pasok siya sa term na Sucesos kasi si Morga, isa siyang government official ng Pilipinas during the Spanish occupation. Kasi, he served as a lieutenant governor ng city of Manila. And then, he is also a member of the audiencia. So, yung audiencia, kung i-convert siya into today's time, yan yung Supreme Court. So, the audiencia is the colonial administrative and judicial body, yung court during the Spanish occupation. So, because of the position of Morga sa Philippine government during the Spanish colonization, it added to the credibility sa credibility nitong librong ginawa niyang Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas. So, itong work niya is considered as an important source para mas maintindihan natin yung early colonial history ng Philippines and makita din natin yung broader context of Spanish imperialism in Southeast Asia. So, yeah. Eto, yun nga. He was sent to Manila as Lieutenant Governor of the Philippines. So, almost paulit-ulit na na-discuss na natin to. Let's move forward. Bakit pinili ni Rizal yung librong Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas? Una, kasi according to Rizal, mas makatotohanan yung mga writings ni Morga compared sa mga other religious writers. Kasi syempre pag mga religious writers, usually yung mga works nila may mga parang mala fairy tale yung story nila. So may mga tales of miracles na hindi na masyadong makatotohanan. Kaya mas pinili niya yung book na Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas. Pangalawa, gusto niyang magkaroon ng parang Filipino-made na book about the pre-colonial Philippines. Kasi sabi ni Rizal, mukhang wala pang book about the pre-colonial Philippines na naisulat ng isang Filipino. So, yan. Gustong, yan yung isa sa objective ni Dr. Jose Rizal. Pangatlo, mas pinaniniwalaan ni Rizal yung gawa ni Morga kasi nga it was based on the first hand experiences ng isang lieutenant general and member of royal audiencia. So ibig sabihin credible yung source or credible yung author ng book na ginamit ni Rizal. And third, it was more civil as opposed to the more prominent religious or ecclesiastical history of the Philippines. Yan, nasabi na natin yan. So, influence of Lumentritt on Rizal. So, we already discussed this during the midterms, but just to refresh your memory, yun nga, naging close ni Rizal si Blumentritt. Although LDR sila, so hindi sila nagkikita. Isang beses lang sila nagkita. So, as what I have discussed last during your midterm topic, naging close ni Rizal si Blumentritt although na magkalayo sila. So, kasi si Blumentritt interested din siya sa pag-aaral ng Filipino culture. So, nag-aaral siya ng Filipino language, interested siya sa Philippine history. Hanggang sa nalaman niya ni Rizal, and then ginawa ni Rizal, nag-send siya ng libro, and then nag-send din ng libro si Blumentritt. So, yan. So, ang mga ginawa naman ni Blumentritt, trinanslate niya yung few chapters ng Noli Mitanghere ni Rizal into German language. Si Blumentritt din, sinulat niya yung preface ng second book ni Rizal, which is El Filibusterismo. Although, yun nga, parang ayaw din ni Blumentritt na maipublish sana yung El Filibusterismo kasi he believed na yun yung magiging mitya sa pagkamatay ni Rizal. But although yun yung paniniwala niya, ginawa niya pa rin ng preface yung El Filibusterismo. Yung nung dumating yung point na gusto na din i-publish ni Rizal yung kanyang edition, yung kanyang annotated version ng Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas ni Antonio Morga, si Blumentritt yung napili ni Rizal na sumulat ng prologue nung annotated version nitong book na to. So, yeah, yung influence ni Blumentritt kay Rizal. So, ano naman yung mga purpose ni Rizal or reason behind bakit niya inannotate yung Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas. So when we say annotate, ibig sabihin to comment. So yung bawat phrase or bawat sentence, bawat paragraph ng libro, kinokomentan niya. So sumusura siya ng comment. So that is what you called annotation or annotating. So ito yung reason bakit in-annotate ni Rizal yung successos. First is to awaken the consciousness of the Filipinos regarding their glorious ways of the past. So para daw mamuklat yung mga Pilipino na we are not left behind. Kumbaga, maganda yung pre-colonial times. So, yan yung gustong iparating ni Rizal. So, second, to correct what has been distorted about the Philippines due to Spanish conquest. So, during the Spanish occupation kasi, maraming parang mga mali na maraming, kumbaga ngayon, fake news ang ginawa ng mga Spanyol about the Philippines. So, as a way to correct yung mga fake news na in-spread ng mga Espanyol, yan, in-annotate niya yung libro ni De Morga. And third, to prove that Filipinos are civilized even before the coming of the Spaniards. So, isa kasi sa claim ng mga Espanyol is parang naging mas civilized tayo. Ibig sabihin, may government tayo, may mga technology, may mga umuusbong na yung technology natin daw because of the Spaniards. Dito sa annotation ni Rizal, gusto niyang ipakita na even before pa dumating yung mga Espanyol, talagang sibilisado na tayo. Ibig sabihin, may gobyerno na tayo during that time, may mga kagamitan na din tayo during that time, may mga kasuotan, may mga traditions na tayo na fina-follow even before na nung dumating yung mga Espanyol. So, yun nga, isa sa pinaka-influence ni Blumentritt kay Rizal is siya yung nag-encourage kay Rizal na magsulat. Magsulat daw si Rizal ng book about the pre-colonial history of the Philippines. So, isa to sa mga factors bakit pinush ni Rizal na i-annotate yung libro na Successos de las Islas Filipinas ni Antonio Morga. Yun. On the first objective, Rizal strove to establish that the Filipinos could be proud of their pre-conquest past. Na dapat hindi daw natin ikahiya kung ano yung pamumuhay natin during the pre-colonial period kasi maganda yung pre-colonial times natin. Hindi siya kahiya-hiya. Hindi siya dapat itago. Pangalawa, history as a propaganda weapon. So Rizal aimed to use history as a propaganda weapon. So ayaw nga ni Rizal ng violence, 'di ba? Kaya ang ginagawa niya nagre-revolt siya through his writings, through history. And third objective, para maipakita na advanced na we are civilized even before the Spaniards came. So, yun. Advanced, we have an advanced civilization. Kasi, our ancestors during the pre-colonial times, they already possessed a complex working society and a culture replete with works of art and literature. So, nag-e-exist na din noon yung arts and literature sa Pilipinas. So, eto yung na-found out ni Rizal So, sabi, na-found out niya na even before the Spanish came, yung mga kanununuan natin, they already possessed a working and legislative system. So, may gobyerno na noon, may mga korte-korte na din during the pre-colonial time. Pangalawa, mataas yung literacy rate ng mga Pilipino noon. So, kasi before na dumating yung mga Espanyol, may tinatawag na tayong baybayin. So, hindi alibata, it is baybayin. At nung discover to ng mga Espanyol, in-exploit nila yung baybayin, and then pinag-aralan nila to and inabuso. At the end, naabuso yung baybayin. Third, may mga weapons na din yung tao during mga Filipino during the pre-colonial times. So, our ancestors were very proficient in the art of war. Kasi even before the Spaniards came, may mga na-invento na tayong swords, mga pana, and may idea na din yung mga kanunuan natin how to make fire guns, mga barrel, and as well as cannons. It was also found out that during the pre-colonial times, meron tayong smooth foreign relation. So, the pre-colonial Filipinos had already established trading. So, di ba, na-discuss natin na parang because of the Spaniards, naging open yung Philippines sa pagkikipag-trade sa Mexico and other colonies of Spain. But it was found out na kahit bago pa dumating yung mga Espanyol, nakikipag-trade na tayo sa mga countries, for example, sa Middle East. And last one, self-sufficient. Ibig sabihin, hindi tayo mayaman yung mga kanununuan natin during the pre-colonial times. So, hindi sila naghihirap. Kasi in terms of food, maraming pagkain noon. So, hunting, di ba? Usually hunting yung mga yung ginagawa nila. So, available yung mga food resources sa Pilipinas during the pre-colonial times. So, yan yung mga na-found out dahil sa book na Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas. So, now, let's compare and contrast yung view naman ni Rizal and Morga with regard to the Filipinos and the history. So, sabi ni Morga, yung Philippines daw, walang naninirahan. It is deserted and uninhabitable. Hindi siya kayang pamuhayan ng isang tao. Yan yung claim ni Morga. But, inannotate to ni Rizal, nag-comment dyan si Rizal. So, sabi ni Rizal, sabi ni Ptolemy daw, the Philippines has 3 islands na inhabited. Ibig sabihin, may mga naninirahan na mga tao doon sa 3 islands sa Pilipinas. In terms of climate, yung winters and summers daw are opposite of those in Europe. While, sabi naman ni Rizal, kung ano yung climate sa Spain, yun din yung parang klima sa Pilipinas. In terms of plant species, sabi ni Morga, na-observe niya na yung Philippines is abundant in ginger, vinegar, and betel. this was agreed by Rizal. So, wala siyang comment about sa plant species. In terms of society, sa body tattoo, so, sabi ni Morga, sa pagtatattoo daw, ang ginagawang una is nagdo-drawing muna ng mga pattern bago maglagay ng black powder. And this was agreed by Dr. Jose Rizal. In terms of indigenous people, na-observe ni Morga na hindi daw safe yung mga tribes. Ibig sabihin, bahiyulente yung mga nasa tribo. While sabi ni Rizal, hindi naman violente yung mga tribes, but they are only protective of their culture. And they are against the inhuman ways of the friars. Kaya ganun yung pag-uugali ng mga tribo. So, hindi sila violente, but it is just a form of self-protection. In terms of women, sabi niya, men money-loving, women are covetous. Sabi naman ni Rizal, kalat-kalat yung mga babae. We find it everywhere. In terms of government, sabi niya, neither kings or queens rule the islands but principals among the natives. So, this was agreed by Dr. Jose Rizal. In terms on the belief on crocodiles, so sabi ni Morga, kinakatakutan. But, sinasamba, we venerate crocodiles. Sabi naman ni Rizal, same reasons for other nations having great esteem for lion and bear. For healers, sabi ni Morga, marami daw ng mga mangkukulam, mga wizards and sorcerers which deceive people. And then, naniniwala daw yung mga Filipino in superstitious beliefs. In terms of death, na-observe ni Morga na yung mga patay, they nililibing nila sa kanya-kanilang mga bahay. And after grieving, ang ginagawa daw ng mga Pinoy is kumakain sila ng marami. They are partying, eating, and drinking. So, sabi naman ni Rizal, Filipinos are more pious to venerate remains of loved ones. Kaya yan yung ginagawa ng mga Pilipino na nililibing nila sa bakuran ng kanilang mga bahay. In terms of economy, sabi ni Morga, Filipinos use cotton to weave blankets. So, medyo agree naman si Rizal. Sabi ni Rizal, Filipinos use cottons to make cotton textile. So, artifacts. So, pag may nakukuha daw yung mga Pilipino ng mga artifacts, gaya ng old jars, etc., binibenta daw ng mga Pilipino sa mga Japanese through trade. Kaya nga, it was found out na during the pre-colonial time, existing na yung trading system. And this was agreed by Rizal. In terms of gold, isa daw sa na-observe ni Morga is isa sa mga job ng mga Filipino is to mine gold. So, ginagamit nila yung mga gold na namimina nila para i-trade nila for rice, pigs, carabaos, and blankets. So, sabi naman ni Rizal, in terms of gold, the Indios, seeing that wealth aroused the capacity of one state, abandoned work in the mines to save them from vexations of the Spaniards. he also observed si Rizal na yung mga lalaki, usually, trabaho nila is pagkakarpintero and pagbibuild ng mga ships. And yung mga paintings daw ng mga Pilipino during the pre-colonial times were very elegant. So yeah, the manner of dressing. So ano naman kahalagahan ng annotation ni Rizal sa present generation in today's time? So the importance is to awaken in the Filipinos the consciousness of our past. So para maging aware tayo na ay ito pala yung ganito pala yung klase ng pamumuhay during the pre-colonial times. Second, to devote ourselves in studying the future. Third, to prove that Filipinos had a culture of their own prior to colonization. They are not inferior to white man. So, importante daw tong annotation na to sa present generation para patunayan na we are civilized even before the Spaniards came. Next, to shatter the myth of the so-called indolence of the Filipinos. So, para, diba kasi sabi, mga Indios, mga lazy, mga bobo. So, para mabago yung pagtingin na yan, yan. Isa sa importansya ng annotation is to prove na hindi tayo lazy. Kasi during the pre-colonial times, maraming ginagawa yung mga ninuno natin. And next, to reduce those Filipinos who deny their native language to a rotten fish. Then, to seriously study Filipino and to embrace the term Indio or Filipino with all its negative connotations and turn it into one of dignity and nobility. So, that ends our discussion about Rizal's annotation of Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas of Antonio de Morga. Thank you.